Hey guys, Justin Bryant here from selfmadesuccess.com, and I made a video recently about how to build up your Google Plus following using tactics that get you targeted followers that actually are interested in your brand, interested in your niche, in the content that you put out. The reason you do that is to get you more sales, more leads, and more traffic. So, to do that, you need to also keep in mind that one of those big strategies that I teach, that a lot of people might teach about when you're starting out trying to get your first followers, you need to learn how to manage your Google Plus followers. You need to learn how to get the ones that aren't following you back and unfollow them. That means they're not interested in your brand. That means they're probably not going to follow you back in the future. So after a while, you'll get an account that will be following a bunch of people who don't follow you back, and it just clutters up your Google Plus homepage with a lot of posts that you don't care about, and it makes you look like you're just following people to get followers and not actually interested in who you're following. So you need to learn how to manage your Google Plus followers, and I have a great tool for that I'm going to share with you. And don't worry, it's free. You can actually upgrade to a paid version, but I tend to use the free version just because I don't need a lot of time to do what needs to be done for this, and I'm going to show you step by step what to do so you can better manage your Google Plus followers. So the tool I use here is it's called Circloscope. Okay, so this is what it looks like. You log in, you go to Circloscope, you just type it in Google and it'll come up. You can either get the upgraded version or the there's like a Chrome store version if you use Google Chrome as your browser, and they call it, you know, free beta, as you can see up here. And what it does is it categorizes your followers into all these different categories. Here's the dashboard. It shows you, you know, your circles, who's in your different circles, your relationships with these people, relevance to your niche or whatever your profile is about, the amount of followers that they have, so you can see how popular they are. You can see who's been inactive, which is another big one. You want more engaging people on Google Plus to follow you, so they'll actually interact with your posts. And you can see the engagers of specific posts, people that have engaged with your past content on Google Plus before, who have either plus one'd, shared, you know, left a comment on your post in the past, will be categorized in these. You can look at their profiles. You can see shared circles, you can see community members and posters, events going on. You can import emails, and you know, you can see your history list, miscellaneous. There's all kinds of things you can do with this, but the main thing I use it for is just to manage my following on Google Plus. And you know, I've already done a post on Pinterest where it was actually a video where I teach you how to do that with like Microsoft Excel or Google Docs to make a spreadsheet and you keep track of it that way. But that's very time consuming, but that's only because there's no Circloscope related tool for Pinterest that really works very well. Or there's a lot of different ones for Instagram and Twitter where you can do this, and I'll go over those in future posts. But anyway, with Circloscope, as you can see, I have way too many people circled. Like, the ratio to followers to people I've circled is pretty bad. And that's because I've never really cleaned them out much, you know. But I'm getting to where I don't really need to follow that many people anymore. So I can actually now go through and unfollow these people. You don't want to unfollow, you know, hundreds of people per day because then it sends a red flag to Google saying, "Hey, this person might be, you know, doing something shady. We might need to block their account for a while, or they might have gotten hacked or something." So just do maybe 100 a day, maybe 50 a day, whatever. But if you're using the follow technique where you follow people who engage with your competition or other big brands in your niche, if people engage with those posts, they're probably interested in that niche, obviously, and they would be interested in your stuff too, because you're in the same niche. You're hopefully posting valuable content, which is very important. So, if you're using the follow method of getting targeted followers on Google Plus, or just trying to build your brand in general, build your traffic, this is what I recommend you use. Okay, so what you do is to get rid of these people that aren't following you back. You go to dashboard, you go to relationships, and then you go to not following back. Okay, followers is just people following you, whether they're in circles or not. That's more of a general thing. If it says not following back, that's people that are you are following but aren't following you, which means they're probably not interested in your brand. If they're following back, that means you're both following each other and it's a mutual interest in each other's stuff. And then this means a one-way follower, which means they follow you, but you didn't follow them back for whatever reason. So we're going to go to not following back, and then it'll list all these people that aren't following you back. Okay, as you can see, I'm following 1,163 people that aren't following back. This, of course, accumulated over the course of a very long time of doing this strategy off and on, experimenting with how many people actually follow back and if this method really works. It does work. A small percentage of people follow you back, and you can get some valuable followers from doing this, but you might not want to rely on it. But if you're going to use it, you might want to clean this out every once in a while, because you might have noticed that when you go to Google and search for something, it might show up with people that you're following in your search results for things they post on Google Plus. Or you might just be trying to get on Google Plus, like right here, and you're getting a bunch of posts that you don't care about, maybe, and you want to unfollow these people. This is the fastest way to do it. Obviously, you can upgrade and just do this in bulk, which I might actually consider doing now that I have way too many people that I'm following. But since I get quite a few followers following me per day without me having to follow anybody, just through posting content and through my blog and my video channels and things like that, I don't need to follow a lot of people anymore, so I can clean out more. You might be in a different level of your business, but all you do when you want to unfollow people is you go to this X, which says remove from all circles. It'll ask you to confirm this, make sure this is what you want to do, and then you press OK. Alright? So then it removes them. You can see this thing down here. It says one removed, and then you just go to the next one. I recommend you just, you know, you do the one in the top right corner here. When you're doing this, it's faster. If you're going to use the free version, as you can see, when you use it up here, when you go through the list up here, your mouse is already very close to the button that says OK. All right? So you'll be able to go through it a lot faster without moving your hand too much, and it'll be a lot less scrolling and stuff like that. So now if I was gonna do this one way down here, you know, you go over here, press OK. I mean, it's not much work or anything, but that's just how I prefer to do it, and it's not a big difference really. But you know, Circloscope is you know, by far the best Google Plus tool I know of for managing followers. So you can go to Circloscope up here and get the free version. It's actually a add-on to your Google Chrome toolbar. So then you can just go up here and click it. It'll come up, and then you can manage your followers here. And then, of course, there's a lot of other functions here that I've showed you that you can kind of go through, or you can even upgrade if you want to do this faster if you're using this method more than maybe I am. Okay, so that's about it for this video. I just wanted to quickly show you a great tool, great process for managing your Google Plus followers and unfollowing people that don't following you, that don't follow you back. And this is the best way to do it, really. And hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, if you got value from it, if you learned something you didn't already know, please like it. Please subscribe. I'm gonna have more great videos like this coming your way. And don't forget to leave a comment of what you thought about the video, or if you have something to add to it. You know, I love it when people have something to say to kind of add to the conversation and get a conversation going to help more people. And you might even teach me something that I don't already know, which is great. I love to learn new stuff. And don't forget to visit us at selfmadesuccess.com. We'll have more great resources, tools, and more advanced stuff there for you. And well, that's the end of this video. This is Justin Bryant from selfmadesuccess.com. And like I said, we taught you how to unfollow people that don't follow you back on Google Plus and how to manage your followers. Hope you got a lot of value from it, and I'll see you in the next video. Hope you have a great day.